We should get out of here. I don't think this place is safe.
I need some answers. You knew more about the Thorian than you let on.
I was afraid. I wanted to stop the tests, but they threatened me. Told me I'd be next. When the Geth attacked, I stayed behind to send a message to Colonial Affairs. I tried to tell them where to find the Thorian, but the power cut before I could send the message. I never meant for this to happen.
You did what you could. I'll help them, if you can tell me where to find the Thorian.
The Thorian is underneath Zoo's Hope, but the entrance is blocked. The colonists covered it with the freighter just before the Geth attacked.
But why are the Geth after the Thorian? What could Saren want with it?
Well, it does have unique mind control capabilities. That's what Exogeny was interested in.
Normandy to shore party, come in.
What is it, Joker?
We're getting a lot of Geth comm chatter. Looks like they're headed your way.
Thanks for the heads up, Joker. You heard the man. Let's move out.
I'm coming with you. I might be able to help. Undo the mess I helped create.
Feros colony. Please, help us.
You can't do this, John.
Everyone shut up. Let me think.
What's going on?
You won't get away with this.
Get her out of here!
Get away from her, you son of a bitch!
Lisbeth!
Damn it! Come out where I can see you! All of you! Shepard, damn it. I knew it was too much to hope the Geth would kill you. I found some interesting facts about you in the exogenic database. I know what happened on a coup. This doesn't have to end like that.
We can talk this out. Nobody needs to get hurt.
You don't understand. It's not that easy. Communications are back up. Exogeny wants this place purged.
This is a human colony, Jong. You can't just repurpose us.
It's not just you. There's something here far more valuable than a few colonists.
You're after the one unique thing Feros has, the Thorian.
The what?
It's a telepathic life form living under Zeus' hope. It's taking control of the colonists there. Exogeny knew all along.
You won't get away with this, Jong.
So you keep saying, but nobody's gonna miss a few colonists.
You've gone way too far. This ends now.
If that's the way it has to be, heck, come on!
As if we don't have enough problems. Now we're shooting each other in the back.
It's my fault. I knew what was going on, and I didn't do anything.
Don't you start. You do good work, and you know it. So what now, Commander?
I'll deal with the Thorian. Then make sure you're safe.
The colonists won't let you near the Thorian. They die first. They're under its control.
What else am I supposed to do?
There's gotta be another way.
I think there is. You could safely use a nerve agent to neutralize the colonists.
Like a gas grenade.
Releasing clouds of nerve gas doesn't seem like a particularly good idea.
It's not like it's weapons grade. The insecticide we use in the grow labs contains trace amounts of tetraclopine, a neuromuscular degenerator. If their nervous systems are already weakened, it may act as a paralyzing agent.
A reduced capacity concussion grenade might suit our needs.
Sounds good. I'll do what I can.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Commander.
We'll stay out of your way until you clear a path.
should ask for their help.
I was hoping you'd have a moment to speak with me. I've got a bit of a problem.
What do you need?
I need to retrieve some data. It's not a big job, but it pays well.
I'm listening.
Good. Good. Poking around in the ruins has become a bit too dangerous for me.
People are quick to assume we enjoy being in hazardous situations.
It's not that bad, really. All you need to do is find my console at Exogeni headquarters and drop the data onto this OSD. It's that simple.
I'll look around if I get the chance.
I appreciate it. That data could be worth a lot of money. Of course, this all depends on getting out of here alive.
Tell me about the data I'm getting for you.
Plans for a few prototype mods. I'm a freelancer. Some of my mods are highly sought after.
Why work in the middle of nowhere if your skills are so useful?
Maybe I've got a bit of the frontier spirit in me. That, and the alternative is a bit too secure for my liking. Freelancers don't have to worry about security as much, so long as we keep a low profile.
Time to get moving.
Just keep in mind what I said.
It's almost time, isn't it? Maybe we...
Please try to avoid hurting the colonists. Use the nerve agent I gave you, if you can.
Of infection could have altered a human to that extent. I wonder what is going on here.
No hitting the colonists, even if the Thorian makes them fire on us. That's what the gas grenades are for.
As you order, Commander Shepard.
Get down! tried to fight it, but it gets in your head. You can't imagine the pain. I was supposed to be their leader. These people trusted me. It wants me to stop you, but I won't. I won't!
So much suffering, so much death, yet still they stay and fight.
Can't believe the colony held out as long as it did.
All right, we just need to find this creature and determine what... That is disturbing.
That does not look like any plant I've ever seen. This may be problematic.
Invaders, your every step is a transgression. A thousand feelers appraise you as meat, good only to dig or decompose. I speak for the old growth as I did for Saren. You are within and before the Thorian. It commands that you be in awe.
You gave something to Saren. Something I need.
Saren sought knowledge of those who are gone. The old growth listened to flesh for the first time in the long cycle. Trades were made. Then cold ones began killing the flesh that would tend the next cycle. Flesh fairly given. The old growth sees the air you push as lies. It will listen no more.
I won't let you keep your thralls. Release them, now!
No more will the Thorian listen to those that scurry. Your lives are short, but have gone on too long. Your blood will feed the ground in the new growth!
Of some kind. few more and it will be severely hurt.
Thank you. Thank you.
suppose I should thank you for releasing me.
Is everything all right? Are you hurt?
I am fine, or I will be, in time. My name is Shiala. I served Matriarch Benezia. When she allied herself with Saren, so did I. Benezia foresaw the influence Saren would have. She joined him to guide him down a gentler path. But Saren is compelling. Benezia lost her way.
Are you saying Saren can control minds?
Benezia underestimated Saren, as I did. We came to believe in his cause and his goals. The strength of his influence is troubling.
Benezia sought to turn the river and was swept away.
Asari matriarchs are among the most intelligent and powerful beings in the galaxy. How could one fall under Saren's control?
Saren has a vessel, an enormous warship unlike anything I've ever seen. He calls it Sovereign. It can dominate the minds of his followers. They become indoctrinated to Saren's will. The process is subtle. It can take days, weeks, but in the end, it is absolute. I was a willing slave when Saren brought me to this world. He needed my biotics to communicate with the Thorian to learn its secrets. Saren offered me in trade. I was sacrificed to secure an alliance between Saren and the Thorian.
Then why were the Geth trying to destroy the Thorian?
After Saren had what he needed, the Thorian became a liability. Saren knows you are searching for the conduit. He knows you are following his steps. He attacked the Thorian so you could not gain the cipher.
What's the cipher? And why did Saren need it?
The beacon on Eden Prime gave you visions. But the visions are unclear, confusing. They were meant for a Prothean mind. To truly comprehend them, you must think like a Prothean. He must understand their culture, their history, their very existence. The Thorian was here long before the Protheans built this city. It watched and studied them. When they died, it consumed them. They became a part of it.
So the Thorian taught Saren to think like a Prothean. How?
The cipher is the very essence of being a Prothean. It cannot be described or explained. It would be like describing color to a creature without eyes. To understand, you must have access to endemic ancestral memory, a viewpoint spanning thousands of Prothean generations. I sensed this ancestral memory, the cipher, when I melded with the Thorian. Our identities merged, our minds intertwined. Such knowledge cannot be taught. It simply exists.
I need that knowledge to stop Saren.
There is a way. I can transfer the knowledge from my mind to yours, as I did with Saren. Try to relax, Commander. Slow, deep breaths. Let go of your physical shell. Reach out to grasp the threads that bind us, one to another. Every action sends ripples across the galaxy. Every idea must touch another mind to live. Each emotion must mark another's spirit. We are all connected. Every living being united in a single, glorious existence. Open yourself to the universe, Commander. Embrace eternity. I have given you the cipher, just as it was given to Saren. The ancestral memories of the Protheans are part of you now.
Are you all right? What just happened?
I saw something. It still didn't make any sense.
You have been given a great gift, the experience of an entire people. It will take time for your mind to process this information.
We should get you back to the ship where you can be monitored.
I'm sorry if you have suffered, but there was no other way. You needed the cipher. In time, it will help you understand the vision from the beacon.
I want to know more about you.
There is nothing remarkable about me. I was merely one of Matriarch Benezia's disciples. For nearly 2 centuries, I followed her, learning at her feet. When Benezia revealed her plan to join Saren, she gave her disciples a choice. Only those who were willing had to follow her. Many felt her plan was too dangerous. But I believed in her. I thought she could turn Saren away from his insanity. Instead, we joined him in it.
Do you know what the conduit is? Or where it is?
No, I'm sorry. All I know is that Saren believes the conduit was the key to the Prothean extinction.
Then whatever it is, we can't let him have it.
You have the cipher. In time, your visions will clear. They will lead you to the conduit. I only pray you find it before Saren does.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the Thorian?
When the creature enveloped me, I became part of it. But I still don't truly understand it. So alien, so ancient. Its exact age is impossible to know. It measured time differently. 10,000 years of hibernation broken by a few frantic centuries of activity. Its mind was awesome, magnificent. It transcended all classification. And now it is gone.
Don't tell me you feel sorry for that thing.
The Thorian was a unique life form. A sentient being that lived for 50,000 years, maybe more. There is nothing even remotely like it in the known galaxy. I am grateful you saved me from a life of thraldom. Yet I cannot help but feel some sorrow for the loss of such a rare and remarkable creature.
Now that you're free of the Thorian, what are you planning to do next?
If you allow it, I would like to stay here with the colonists. They have suffered greatly, and I played a role in their suffering. I would like to make amends.
The colonists will need all the help they can get. They'll be happy to have you on their side.
Thank you, Commander. May fortune smile upon you.
You did it. With the Thorian gone, we can start rebuilding for ourselves again. And we're free of Exogeny's threats. We're back to being just a little nowhere colony. Thank you, Commander. It'll be tough going, but we'll make this a home.
You saved most of the infected. It'll take time to recover from the physical effects, but they'll be all right. Thank you.
I will do what I can to assist the colony in this difficult time. I am ashamed of the damage done to the lives of these people.
Farewell, Shiela.
Farewell, Commander. I wish you well in your hunt.
I never thought I would be so thrilled to see a soldier. Forgive my previous inaction, but under the Thorian's influence, every thought was examined and filtered.
What will you do now that the fighting is over?
I may stay, try to recover my losses. I can have new supplies delivered within weeks. Perhaps the colony will survive after all.
Let me see what you have in stock.
Of course. Return in the future, and I may even have more to see.
I can think without pain. Thank you. You've given us a second chance. It's nice to have more mundane worries, like getting that water flowing again.
I could bring in what you need with the Normandy.
That would only help us in the short term, unless you plan to make a trip every few days. We need to be self-sufficient.
I'll look into it if I have time.
I'd appreciate that, Commander.
I should go.
I wish you luck.
Thank you for freeing us.
Thank you. It doesn't hurt anymore. I can think my own thoughts again. We have a chance to start over, thanks to you. Food is still our immediate concern, but we'll manage.
I'll look into it when I get a chance.
Thank you for your help. You've already done so much.
To do here.
Free. I can't believe I'm free.
valve looks like part of a large system. There are likely others we need to activate as well.
Another one. Doesn't look like it's been activated yet, though. We should keep looking.
They tried to build a life here. But now all they have are ruins.
Can't believe the colony held out as long as it did.
Have you given any thought to helping us with our water troubles?
The water's back on again.
Really? I'll need to get the relays going then. Thanks for your help, Commander. Here's a small payment for your trouble.